Hello, this is Maaike from the Dressmakers Academy. I've done some work on this bridal gown and I would love to show you a little bit what I've done. Just to hopefully you can learn something from it and just to show you also a little bit about the way how the inside work of this corset is done. So, okay. As you can see, this is a corset with some boning in it and a mesh layer over it with two shoulder seams here. And when the bride came to me with this dress, she bought it in New York, so it wasn't altered yet. So she came with me to me with this beautiful dress and she put it on, and the first thing I saw was that the whole weight of the dress was hanging on these two very fragile shoulders. So the whole weight was hanging on this mesh. That was also because the bodice was too big for her, so the lining didn't give that much of a structure yet, and the whole dress was hanging down and didn't fit very well. It was not really flattering for her. So the third thing I did was to take in these side seams of this bodice, and I'll show you on the inside here. The boning is beautifully hidden behind these pink ribbons. So what I did is I took out this ribbon, took out the boning, it's a small piece of boning, and then behind that there was the side seam. And you can imagine the seam allowance was like 2 millimeters, 3 millimeters, because this has to fit on it. So I took in the side seams, cut the seam allowance down to 2 millimeters, and placed this ribbon back with the boning in it. Of course, this line changes because, here you can also see it a little bit. Because, when you make something smaller and you need to find this fluid line again. So I had to play a little bit with that and placing this mesh ribbon against it, placing it back. And well, that's the first step I did actually. But the first thing I noticed, as I said before, the whole dress was hanging on its shoulders and it didn't look really nice. So I thought there must be something inside that carries the weight of the dress, and the trick to do that is to make a strap like this. It's a grosgrain strap. It's a grosgrain ribbon. You can buy it online. And what you do is you measure the waist, the circumference, and then make this ribbon just a tiny little bit smaller than the waist is. So let's say, for instance, you take off 1 centimeter. So it really, it still fits, of course, because she has to wear it. It also still needs to be comfortable, kind of. And but it makes the dress hanging on this when you wear it. I added this little bra strap. Yeah, how do you call it? Bra closing. So you can choose also a little bit, and there is a little bit of stretch in it, so it wears comfortable. When you put on the dress, you close this in the waist, and the whole dress is actually then resting on your hips on this band, and that makes that the weight is no longer on the shoulders, and that really helps in fitting. So the moment I place this one in here, the second fitting, it's a world, it's a huge difference. It works super well, and it's a really a trick that's often used in couture sewing. So, yeah, you can play with it. Also with dresses sometimes that look very fluid and almost like there's no anything inside to support the dress. You always find something like this inside. So that was the second step. I hand sewed it onto the waistline. And it works very well. It saves the whole look and feel of the dress. It is beautiful. So third thing, this was quite rough on the skin. The lady is not wearing anything under it because the corset is doing its work very well. So she wanted a little bit of a soft inside. So I placed four pieces of fabric in here that fits beautifully. So as you can see, it works very well. Of course, when you take in these side seams, there's a whole layer on this side of the tulle mesh that also needs to be taken in. That's the seam is going here. It's very invisible also because of the lace pieces. And actually that was the most work doing on this dress, because taking off all these pieces of lace in this area without cutting a hole in the mesh, because that's really dangerous. It's attached with tiny stitches. So I used a magnifying glass to really have a good look at it. But it works well. You take off all the loose pieces, then you take in the side seam, and then you place all the pieces back, and the seam is hidden and invisible again. What I also did, this mesh here, it didn't fit her very well. It was, there were pleats in it, and it was not tight. It was not fitting right. So I also played a little bit with that by taking off some lace here, place the mesh the right way. I pinned it actually on her body, so I could see where should I hand sew it onto the bodies to make it nice and flat and fitting well. So that was also quite some work, but yeah, I love hand sewing, so I really love doing it. Of course, I had to take off this ribbon, shorten it, hand sew it back on. And then also the dress was too long. The lining was okay, the length of the lining, but the tulle was too long. So I had to shorten it 3.5 centimeters. And that's just using a good pair of scissors. I used a large pair and start cutting. But per layer, it took me 1.5 hour to cut it off. So I was only working 3 hours on the layers. And you always think, oh, let's do it, last thing to do, and after the last fitting, because you first want to make sure the bodies fits well, fits perfectly, and then you can determine the last thing of the last job of this dress was to shorten it the right height. So, but there are of course so many meters of tulle in there, so it takes a long time, so don't overlook it. It takes time. So that was it. It was a beautiful job. Oh, what I also would like to tell, I hand sewn this on, but it needs to be very firm. So I used this beeswax to coat my threads, because it gives extra, it makes your threads more stronger than they are already. And that helps with sewing these on. So I'm now sure it won't get loose during dancing or whatever. So yeah, that was this lovely job. The lady is going to marry this afternoon. So I'll bring the dress within an hour to her, and I will show you some or post some pictures of her wearing the dress, and then you can see it. Okay, hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you. Bye-bye.